Hi, my dear students. I'm Jagdish Pupala, MSc MPhil. I'm a physics faculty associated with Narayana IIT Academy from past 15 years. So let us take an example that a string of length L and linear mass density of it is mu, fixed at one end of it and freely suspended, and at the other end of it, if you suspend a block of mass M, then we know that here the tension at any point P is at the point P, tension T is equals to the total weight of the string, or the total weight that is supposed to act at that point will create the tension T at that point. So then tension T will be equals to, here if this part of the length is known, if you take it as x, this is m, then here in this case tension T will be the weight of the block plus this weight of the block is acting plus weight of the string. For L length it is mu, that is mass per unit length, m mass m naught per length L is equals to mu. So for length x it is, for x length its mass is equals to mu into x. Therefore this part of it will become mu into x into g it is, or you can write mg plus m naught by L into x into g will be the tension T of it. So if you know this tension T at this particular point, so here if a pulse is generated and it is propagating through it, the velocity V of this pulse here now, at this point it is tension, it depends on the tension. At this point it depends on the tension at that point, because tension T what we got, it depends on x. So as we are moving up like this, that means x value is increasing. As x is increasing, this value is said to be increasing. So on to the top of it, this T will be maximum. So as the pulse is propagating upwards, as tension T is increasing, now we got velocity of this transverse wave pulse created is equals root over T by mu. This tension T is equal to this much. So here we got mg plus mu x g upon mu, that is the velocity v, which is equals to dx by dt. So as it is going upwards, its velocity goes on increasing. So wave velocity is increasing in this sense, in this case. Wave velocity is increasing simply. The frequency at which the waves are generated, if it is not changing. The wave is changing means wavelength also will be affected. Here in this case, this is the pulse moving upwards with this velocity v. Suppose string is only having mass, there is no such block is connected, there is no block is connected, that means this mg will be absent. No sir, simultaneously we are affecting the weight acting on it, that means we are suspending in liquid so that this block alone immersed in water, then this will not be the force, mg will not be the force, the force will be affected, that means there will be bind force coming into it. So this force will be mg minus bind force. So like that, here in this case the net force acting at this particular point can be affected, so the tension is going to change at that point and hence the velocity of the pulse is going to change. So here in this case pulse is going upwards and pulse is coming downwards in both the cases. Magnitude of the velocity of the pulse will be same at a given point when it is going upwards or downwards, only the direction is going to change. So, time taken by the pulse to move from bottom to top will be same as time taken by the pulse to move from top to this bottom of the string, both will be same. But here in this case, to make it little bit simple, this dx by dt value, okay, to find out in the case of string purely suspended like this, mu is equals to m naught by L, mu is equals to m naught by L, if you consider there is no such a block, then we can take this mg value is equals to 0. So, at this point P, tension T is equals to mu x g, then velocity at that point is equals to root over T by mu, which is equals to root over g times x, which is dx by dt at that particular point P. If this is the thing given, then dx upon root x is equals to root g times dt, which you call it as variable separable method of solving this equation. So, dx by root x is equals to root g times dt. That means, separating same type of variables and differentiable elements onto the same side. This is root g is a constant, bringing dt to the other side of it. On integration, we will get this is equals to 2 root x is equals to root g times t, root g times t it is, provided this x value is changing from, just let us substitute, take the x values are from this bottom to top, that means 0 to L, provided it is the time interval 0 to t. So, 2 root L is equals to root g times t, therefore, time is equals to 2 root of L by g. Now, here, if you just trying to modify the same, dx by dt is equals to root g into d, root g into x, and dx by root x is equals to root g into dt. Again, on integration means, we will write integral dx by root x is equals to integral root g dt, as we got just now root 2 root x running from x is equals to, that is, let us consider from here to midpoint to here, like two steps if you are trying to consider, x is equals to 0 to L by 2, it is again root g into dt. 0 to t1 if you consider. Then here 2 into root over L by 2 minus 0 is equals to root g times t1. So, t1 is equals to simply root over 2L by g. Therefore, time taken by this pulse to move from this midpoint to this one, this bottommost point, this is the topmost point. This is the midpoint, something like B if you consider. This is the bottommost point B, this is C if you consider, center point. Then B to C, it is the time taken. That is from B to C. Therefore, C to A if I ask, time taken. The total time T minus T1, that means 2 into under root over L by G minus under root 2L by G it is. So, root over L by G times of 2 minus root 2 will be the time taken. The wave motion, energy in transition and energy carried by a transverse wave, and hence intensity of that transverse wave is to be discussed. So, here you got a wave pulse created, and if it is transmitted through the string with a velocity v, we got V is equals to root over T by mu, and T is the tension in the string, and mu is the linear density, which is equals to dm by dx over r, mass per unit and total mass of the string by length of it, or we can say rho into area of cross section, where rho is the density, that is volume density we can say, and where A is the area of cross section. So here this wave is transmitted. If you consider small element of it, that means a part of this to be identified like this, length very small, it is striped and it is taken. When it is parallel, let us take its length is represented by dx. At this instant, this part of it is moving downwards with some velocity v. If you consider this velocity of this element or velocity of this particle of mass dm, we can say elemental mass dm, then here for this energy carried by this one is identified as small amount of energy associated with it equals to total kinetic energy, small elemental kinetic energy dk, and potential energy, sum of these two. We need to calculate potential energy, kinetic energy, so that sum of them will be total energy of that element of the string through which transverse wave is transmitted, which makes total energy of that element. And here the summing up over all the elements dx 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 from here to here or here to here like this, that makes the energy carried by that string. So first let us calculate dk, elemental kinetic energy of it dk is equals to, due to the movement of that particle it has kinetic energy, small element, so which is half into mass into kinetic energy, means half into mass into velocity square of that element. So here dk is equals to half into, here dm value can be taken as mu is equals to dm by dx, so we can take dm is equals to mu into dx, and here this is the velocity of the wave with which it is traveling. So here in this case it is mu into dx into velocity of that element square. We know that the displacement of that element from the mean position, average value of it is, average value of the displacement is y, which is equals to a sine of kx minus omega t we have taken. So dy by dt, which is velocity of that element, is minus omega a cos kx minus omega t, minus omega a cos of kx minus omega t. Substituting this element velocity in this, we will get dk is equals to half into mu dx times this velocity square will be omega square a square and cos square of kx minus omega t, and this value of kinetic energy will be half into mu omega square a square cos square kx minus omega t times dx. And here this is kinetic energy of this particular element, like, so per unit length, if you consider this expression, can be rewritten like d k by dx is equals to mu into omega square a square cos square of kx minus omega t. This is kinetic energy per carried by that one per unit length, kinetic energy per unit length. So here dk by dx is equals to half into this mu can be replaced as rho times area of cross section, whereas this is omega square a square cos square kx minus omega t times s, you can take, where for this string, if you take this string, this will be the string if you consider, then this cross section area is taken as a s. So in terms of rho, if you write, it will become s. So here dk by dt, if we consider kinetic energy per unit time that is passing through that string, is equals to half rho omega square a square cos square of kx minus omega t, this one s into dx by dt, dk or dk, which is equals to dx is there. So dk by dt means dx by dt will be there, where mu is replaced with rho into area of cross section. So this dx by dt is velocity of that wave, simply. So this one into v. So here in this case, this is nothing but rate at which kinetic energy is transmitted through that string. Okay, that means amount of kinetic energy passing through it per unit time, that is dk by dt is equals to this much. Now if you calculate potential energy of that one, how much it will be? So this is rate of this kinetic energy transmitted, the potential energy associated with that element. This is ds is equals to that amount of work done in making that string little bit elongated due to tension present in the string. So here at this end tension T, at this end tension T, and while framing at second order differential equation by using from here to here, the angle will be little bit different. So a little bit higher level of mathematics, if we use, you can frame it a second order differential equation. But let us make it little bit simple, so that tension T into elongation will give elastic potential energy stored in that string when the wave is passing through it. Initially it is of length dx, like this smaller one. Now this is in the same length, this is the part of the length is located, means a little bit extension is there. That extension will be tension T into change in the length, final length of it, and initial length of it is taken as dx, like this. Then this value of it can be described as T times of, this is to be evaluated. So here let us take ds is equals to this part of length as under root of dx whole square plus dy whole square, so that ds can be taken as 1 plus half into dy by dx whole square times dx by using binomial expansion. Just bringing dx out of it and rearranging it, and by using binomial expansion, you will get this expression. So that here in this case, this ds minus dx, if you elaborate, it will become t into dx plus half into dy by dx whole square, this one elaborated, minus dx. So that t into half into, again here it will be dx multiplied, so that dy by dx whole square into dx, since these two cancel. Actually, we need to consider here partial differentiation, but as it is beyond the scope of present JEE mains or NCERT syllabus level, so I am just assuming that it is an exact differential, and that too have taken a small elemental length, like, so it is okay with that. So here half into tension T value is to be taken from the velocity of the transverse wave. From this you can take tension T is equals to mu v square, so it is mu into v square, whereas a dy by dx, since y is equals to a sin kx minus omega t, from this dy by dx is a into k into cos kx minus omega t whole square. So du is equals to half into mu into v square k square. V is equals to omega by k. From that, this is v square and this is k square it is. So it becomes omega square a square cos square kx minus omega t times dx. This dx, so into dx. So it is du by dx per unit length, if you consider. It becomes half into, this mu is again replaced with cos square of kx minus omega t into area of cross section. Similarly, if you are trying to write du by dt value of it, du by dt value of it, you will get half rho omega square a square, that too cos square kx minus omega t times area of cross section into v, same as dk by dt. So here, if you come across total energy carried by that string element, if you consider, that is dE value is, now dE by dt value will become dk by dt plus du by dt, which is sum of this one and this one. Both are one and the same, like we are getting. So simply addition of those two will be resulting value equals to dE by dt is equals to, simply the value will become, this is half plus this is half, like adding it, you will get this expression, rho omega square a square cos square kx minus omega t into s into v, where s is the cross sectional area of the string. So this is nothing but power, rate of energy transferred is what you call the power of it, simply the power of the transverse wave, power carried by transferred through transverse wave along the string. That is the meaning of it. So now here, if you come across wave intensity, another important point, that is nothing but amount of energy carried per unit time, per unit area of cross section, is the intensity of it, or this P by power by cross sectional area through which it is passing. That means per unit area of cross section per unit time, the amount of energy transmitted is simply called intensity of that wave transmit. This P by S value will become rho omega square A square cos square kx minus omega. Now in this, if you calculate average value of this power and if you go for it, then it will become half rho omega square A square, since average value of power P will become half rho omega square A square into S, rho omega square A square by S into V, into S into V will be the expression for it. So here into V will be the expression for it. So this is intensity of the transverse wave carried through a stretched string, okay, whose area of cross section is S and the tension that string is T. So in JE means they are just concentrating on that intensity of the wave carried or the power or the amount of energy carried per unit length. That means potential energy per unit length plus similarly the kinetic energy per unit length is to be taken.